Hi there. This is the second part of a tutorial I'm making to show how to make a scene something like this. This is actually where we ended up in the first part, and I'll put a link to the first part of the tutorial in case you missed it in the description. So I'm quite pleased with how this scene is turning out. It may even end up better than the first render I did. Possibly I could have made the leaves slightly smaller than they are, but I quite like the amount of light that's shining through the leaves and the variation in them. And you can even see there's some redness showing up down here because of the translucence of the leaves, as well as the sun reflecting through them. I like also how dark the bark of these trees is and how it contrasts very well with the bright colours of the leaves. In this part of the tutorial, I'm going to improve the texture of the ground a little, which I didn't do in my first version. I'm going to add a little bit of bump to it before we then add some particle grass, and I'll add a plate behind the trees here to give a more realistic sky. In fact, it'll be a photographic sky. And I think we'll just sharpen the sun up a little as well. So although it's low in the sky, I think we want slightly sharper shadows than that. So as that's an easy thing to do, we'll do that straight away. I'll just turn off the visibility of all my particles just to make everything work a little better. And there's our sun, and it's currently set to 0.010, so we'll go to 0.005, so half the size. So the next thing we're going to do is play around with the texture of the land a little bit. So I'm opening up a new window. We'll go to the usual node editor, select the landscape, and let's have a look. So of course we've got this version of the landscape which varies with height, which is why it all turns into pretty much the rock texture back here. Now although you can see a lot of tiling artifacts from this angle, from the camera angle, it doesn't show up too much, and of course it shows up worse in preview than it does in a final render. So that's not too bad as it goes, but we do need to add a little bit of bump to it. And I'm going to make that very simple. I'm not even going to worry about having a different bump texture for the grass compared to the ground, because really this green color isn't going to be that visible. Certainly it'll only show shining through the actual grass that we add. So this is our stone texture, and I'm going to add a vector node, which is a bump node. I'm going to drop that there, and I'm going to take the color output of my image texture for the sand and pebbles into the height for that bump. The next thing I'm going to do is take the normal from that bump and plug it into the normal on the diffuse. Immediately you can just about see, I'll zoom in a little bit, that we've got something going on there. Because we haven't really got any shininess on the texture at the moment, it doesn't show that well. So I'm also going to add a mix shader, put that there, and then a glossy shader, set to my preferred method, which is Ashmin Shirley. Make sure it's at full white, and then connect that in. Now I haven't connected the bump to it yet, and it's also quite a high level. So in actual fact, we've got a lot of shininess there. You can see it's reflecting the sky a lot. So even before I change all of that, I'm going to drag now the bump into the normal of that glossy. And immediately you can see lots of little highlights. So we'll leave the roughness roughly where it is for the moment, but we'll turn the factor of the shininess down to, let's try 0.015. So we're back to something a little bit more normal, but probably the bump is still a little bit extreme. So we can change the strength of that and drop it down. We can also experiment with inverting it to see if that gives us a better effect. Now, in reality, we should be using a bump map. Obviously, we can create bump maps from things like this, or we can create our own bump maps in Blender. Crazy bump is what you can use, but for a barely visible bump like this, I don't think it's really that worth worrying about. So I'm going to turn the strength down a fair way so it starts to become a little bit more reasonable. And then we just try not seeing a lot in it. I'm going to go with the inverted version, and let's see what that looks like from the normal camera view. So that just adds a little bit of something, maybe a little bit more. We've got some fairly sharp lines here, but they should be smoother when we actually do a proper render. And if they're not, we can increase the subdivisions, but bear in mind it will affect the position of your particles, so you'll have to go around that again. So that's finished texturing the landscape for the moment. And what I want to do now is define where my grass is. So let's have a look at what we've got in terms of vertex groups. So I selected vertices, and pretty much that's where I want the grass to be. Now, really, I don't want the grass to cut off quite like that. So I'm going to say plus, and I'm going to call this grass, and assign to that. So it's essentially the same as the trees one at the moment. But what I'll now do is go into weight paint mode, and you can see it's not too bad actually, but what I'm going to do is blur that a little bit. So if we come up to here, we can select the blur brush, and then if I move along this line here, as you'd expect, it's blurring it. So the blue, which is unselected near the edge of the line starts to turn green, and the red, which is fully selected around the line, starts to turn yellow, which is obsolete. So they're basically closing in on each other, and we don't want it completely uniform. Not that it matters that much up there. I probably don't even need grass there, actually. And that's a good point. So next thing to do is come out of weight paint mode, go to the camera view, and I'm now going to just select everything that the camera can see and slightly beyond. So this is all the area that I need at most to have grass on. Now, it's not entirely true, because you can see there's little undulations in the landscape, so it's missed a few bits. So what I will do is just fill that in, because some of the grass might just be poking up over what is essentially the horizon, of course. And you can even see actually that there's a few little bits up here. I can just about see a few vertices here that need selecting. So what I've got selected now is everything plus a little more that I'm likely to be able to see in the camera. I'm just adding a little bit more now. So I'm now going to go to select and inverse. Selecting my grass, I'm going to say remove from that vertex group, unselect everything, and then say select. And you can now see that's all filled in. I forgot that I should have removed the path first. So what I'll do now is go to my trees, select my trees options, go back to grass, and just say select, inverse, and remove. And again, if I select that, now we can see we've got the grass selected where we can see it, but the path itself is removed. Now, because I did that in a slightly funny order, I'm just going to go back to weight paint. And it's not too bad, actually. I'll perhaps blur it a little more just to give a little bit more randomness to the edge of the path. And we can also use a mix mode here to sort of drag the grass around a little bit. It looks very crude, and it is, but on the other hand, the particles will be randomized somewhat. And then I'm just going to use a blur brush on that just to smooth that out, and perhaps a subtract brush, because we've got a bit too much grass on the path just there, right in front of the camera. Okay, so that's our grass area defined. So we now need to go and make some grass particles. So I've gone into the layer with my trees, not for any particular reason, but this is where I'm setting up my assets. So I'm just going to add a plane initially, look from above, and E to extrude, proportional editing off, take that up to somewhere like that, E to extrude again, and then somewhere about there, Alt M, and then add a central vertex line, and then we can just take that end down and scale it in a little bit. That gives us a sort of rounded grass blade. I'm going to just move these out proportionately that way. I'm making a very large grass blade at the moment, obviously. I'm going to add another set of vertices there. I don't want to add too many vertices to this, so I'm probably already adding a few too many. In fact, I'm going to delete those. We don't really need them. They're not going to be visible, but we do need a few vertices along the length. So I'm going to scale that on the Y now, just to make it a lot thinner. Bring that up and open those out a little bit. I'm really just trying to get a sort of slightly rounded shape to the end of the grass. Now I'm going to go into edit mode, select all the vertices, press U, project from view, bounce. We'll open a new window up, go to the UV image editor, and I'm going to open my textures. And I've got, roughly speaking, a grass texture here. I like it because it's got a sort of granular effect to it, and it's lighter at one end than it is at the other. So we'll open that image. And you can see it's the wrong way around at the moment. So I'm going to rotate my grass 90 and scale on the X, and then scale on the Y. You only have X and Y, of course, in a UV image. And I can see that's the tip of my grass, and that's the base. So I'm now just going to add the grass material. We'll just give it a very basic image texture at the moment, and we'll use that grass texture. So if I go to my texture mode, you can see the tip of my blade of grass is darker than the base. It's not essential, but it just adds a little bit of extra detail. So we've got a bit more modeling to do now. So I'm just going to select that central row of vertices and just pull them down slightly so the grass has a little bit of shape in that direction. I'm going to select those N3 vertices, look from the side, turn proportional editing on, and rotate, and just bring it down like that. So I've increased with Control Plus the vertices that I've got selected, and increased again. Not happy with how those two are positioned. So I'll just drop them down a little bit more. I'm looking through now, I'm in wireframe mode just to help with the editing. Just makes it a little easier. I could, of course, have modeled this properly by doing just half of it and then adding a mirror modifier. But for something as simple as a blade of grass, that's not really necessary. But I'm just adding a little bit of curve to the whole thing so that it sort of bends outward, at least for this particular blade. You can, of course, add a lot less vertices than this, and that will help you with the render because it'll be using a lot less memory. But apparently using objects for particle systems rather than the strand renderer is more memory efficient anyway, for some reason. Possibly Blender was optimized for that. I think I'm going to join these two together. So I'm pressing K, which is the knife tool, select that point, select a point somewhere on the middle, and then select that point and press space, and now they're joined together, which means I can now add a little bit more bend to the end there without it deforming. So that's a very simple blade of grass we've got there, and I'll set it to smooth shading, which basically will just hide those sharp bends to a certain extent. So I'll make another one, and this one I'm going to put a much sharper bend on, and we'll perhaps make that one a little thinner as well. Take another copy, and you can keep going like this for quite some time if you want to. The idea really is to just give some randomness to the shape, not just the size. You can only go so far in your random variations with the particle system itself. You really do want the blades of grass to look somewhat unique as they are in nature. So I've actually shortened that one as well. Now I've just realized, of course, our origin point is in the wrong place. So with all the vertices selected, need to put that just below the bottom of the blade of grass. And I'll do that for all of these. Otherwise, everything below the origin is going to disappear below the ground. And now I'm going to take these two, copy them, put them to one side, make another copy, scale it down a little. So I'm looking end on now, and I'm going to rotate that one about there. I'm going to rotate that one, something like that, and I'm going to bring them together. So what I'm actually going to make is a little grass plant, and I'll join them together in a moment. If you want to scale on a given axis, but you've rotated the object, so let's say you want to scale on the object's y-axis, but the object is no longer aligned along its y-axis, just press scale and then S for scale, then Y and Y again, and that will then scale on the local axis for the object rather than the global one. So let's just tilt those out a little more, and maybe add one more blade of grass, which will make quite a bit smaller. Okay, so we'll select those and join them. While I'm here, I'm going to set the viewport color of the material to some kind of grassy green. I'm going to duplicate these. By rights, I should make each one slightly different again, but all I really want to do is have the proportionate number of these much higher than this single object here, just so that when they are duplicated by the particle system, this is outnumbered by these, because I want individual blades of grass more than I want groups of grass like this. But it's up to you. You can obviously build... the first one I did, I used groups of grass like this, but it's harder to infill with these because they're already clumped. So let's just select them all, Control-G, and call it the grass group. So we're ready now to go and add some grass particles to our landscape. So we'll go to Particle Systems, and we'll duplicate the leaves one to begin with. So we'll add a new particle system, we'll call it Grass, but we'll select the leaves particle system, click the two so that we make it a unique particle system, and then call that Grass. We'll go with 2,500 for the moment, and we'll use the Grass Vertex group, and you can see how that's altered it, and we'll change to the Grass group. So they're quite large at the moment, but they're looking quite good already actually, apart from being rather large. So let's set the size to 0.001. Probably a little too small, so 0.005. So initial orientation for grass, I want to be global Z, so it grows upward, but with a little bit of random added into it for realism. So let's have a look at what that's looking like. We can't really see until we render it. So yeah, they're still a bit too big, and obviously not enough of them, but we'll fix that in a moment. So let's put the size down to 0.003, and then we're going to come down to children. Now we've currently got 2,500 particles. I'm going to turn the render off for a moment, because when I turn children on, it's going to go to some default values. So I'm going to go for interpolated. If you do simple, it will simply create another particle for each particle that you have in here, multiplied by the numbers we have in here. You can see it's very simple. Sometimes that's what you want, but more often you want a particle that is not exactly the same as its parent or parents. So interpolated We'll take a couple of particles that are already there and then create a new particle that is somewhere between the first and the second in terms of size and orientation and things like that. So that then gives you a smoother representation of additional particles. It just looks a lot better. Now, I don't want 100 times 2,500, although you might do if you were really going to do a whole field of grass. I once did a render with approximately 1,000,000 grass particles in it, and it still rendered, although whether it would render with the current version of Blender is another matter. So that's just 10 times, so that's 25,000 particles we're rendering. So let's see what that looks like. Well, starting to look a little better. It's still possibly a little long, but clearly needs a lot more particles. So rather than just keep putting the children up, what I prefer to do is to start to increase this number, because if you just have the children too high, then effectively you start to see a sort of pattern emerging because you don't have enough parents. However, before we do that, I'm going to add a few other things. So I'm going to say long hair, which will allow you to have some particles that are a little longer than normal. Change the uniform value slightly, which actually randomizes it a little bit. And we'll add a little randomness here. We can add some curl. We'll keep the amplitude fairly low. So let's put this up to 20,000. So that's 200,000 blades of grass in reality. Now we start to see something. Now at this point, I'm going to switch down to CPU render because it's much more likely I'm going to have a crash using GPU render with this many particles. So we need more randomness in there, but that's starting to look okay. We need to do some more work on the grass texture itself, and I think we need some more randomization in it as well. So I think I'm going to drop the number of particles down a little bit. We'll go for 10,000, which of course is 100,000 particles. I'm going to add some more randomness to the initial orientation, and we can also add some randomness to the size, and we can add some Brownian as well, which will also randomize it a bit. And I've increased the number of virtual parents. So let's go back to this layer name and play around with our grass texture. So I'm going to go back to GPU render. And we've got a nice enough texture on them, but if you look from the other side, all we're getting on there is reflected light. We're not getting any transmitted light. So the first thing I'm going to do is add an add shader, drop that there, add a translucent shader, plug that into there, and you can see it's gone white on this side because it's adding white translucent light. So all the light coming through becomes white. But of course I need to put this texture in, and it's much better. But light coming through should be a deeper colour and certainly somewhat darker. So I like to add a gamma node just into there and then increase that number, which is what deepens and darkens it. About 1.8 seems to be a good value. And now we've got grass that transmits light. We also want grass that has a shiny element to it. So I'm going to now add a mix shader, put that there, add a glossy shader, set to Ashkimin, full bright, plug that into there. Way too shiny at the moment. So we'll set that to 0.015 and just have a look around, see what we can pick up. Perhaps drop the roughness down to 0.05. And now what I want to do is add some fake texture to the grass. Now I could do what I did in the other one, but all I'm actually going to do for such a small thing is add a noise texture, plug that factor into displacement, turn the displacement up, let's try 25. It's way too heavy at the moment. So I'm now going to add a math node, set to multiply, and turn the value down. Because of the way that it is UV mapped, it's actually giving us almost streaks along the grass, which is just what we want. So let's try 0.05, and you can see we're getting some nice reflections there. Perhaps need to turn the roughness up. Let's try 0.075, so they're not quite so sharp, and the factor down to 0.01. So what that should do is give us some variation in the grass depending on how the light we see coming from it reaches us, whether it's going through the grass or reflecting off the grass. So we go back to our scene. We've actually got quite a lot of grass that we don't need in this scene. So I'm going to turn off the visibility of our grass particles for a moment. Go to edit mode in wireframe and then just select some of these vertices out here. Be careful not to select ones right next to the camera view because they will reach in to the camera view, especially with subdivision surfaces. And then I'm just going to say remove on the grass vertex group. So if I now select that, you can actually see I've got some missing here. So I'm just going to add a few more in. We want some that run just past the camera because grass blades might be coming into the camera view from off the camera. So let's see what our particles look like now. Let's try a GPU render. So that's not looking too bad. I think we can go slightly down on the size of the particles, but increase the number of them again. So let's go for 20,000. but turn the size down to 0.002. So that's looking pretty good. Obviously you can play around with higher densities of grass and things like that, but what you can also do is play around with the density of the grass down here. I'm just going to turn children off for a moment just to make it work a little quicker. Under textures we can say new, we can then go to that texture, change it to clouds. We can try different options on that, such as the size and the depth and things like that. But make sure instead of influencing time, it influences density and possibly size. So if we now go back to our grass, I'll turn the children on again. You can see that's possibly a bit extreme. So if I go back to materials, and rather than a density and size impact of 1, let's try 0.5 and 0.5 for the size as well. Maybe 0.25 for the density. So if we render that, and so on. So I'm going to turn all the particles on and give that another render, but I'm going to switch to CPU mode for that because we're probably coming up against the limits of my GPU now. So there's the leaves and there's the trees. So I just did a render at 75% here just to speed it up a little bit rather than 100%, and just 15 samples. So really you'd want to render this at a little bit more than 15 samples. And you can see it's a little bit noisy in places, but in the final part of this series, I'll go through both how to add a little volumetric effect. So we've got some sunbeams coming through the trees, and I'll also talk about how to minimize the effect of this noise so that you can have a more pleasing image. And you can see that the grass as well needs a little bit more randomization because the height is exactly the same across most of these blades of grass. So we need a little bit more work there. But overall, I think the composition of this scene may even be better than the first one that I did. We'll also add a plate behind this image. So basically just a flat plane, but with an image of a real sky on it, just to help to enhance this a little bit. So it looks like we're sort of on a little hill with a load of trees along it and walking along a path. But I think we'll call a halt to it there, as the volumetric side of it is quite an extensive element. So I'll cover that in the next and final part of this tutorial. So I hope you found that interesting. If you did, let me know. To enjoy these tutorials, don't forget to click subscribe. And if there's any suggestions or requests for future tutorials, I'm more than happy to see them. So thanks a lot, and I'll see you in the next part.